Caroline Kennedy, what an honor to sit here with you and talk about this really unique element of the Apollo.
We're so excited because we're celebrating the 50th anniversary of the Apollo moon landing.
We choose to go to the moon in this decade and do the other things, not because they are easy, but because they are hard.
So I've learned so much about my father's vision and about the 400,000 people who worked to make it a reality.
The Eagle has landed.
And some of them were even here in Massachusetts.
And they were, and that's the unique element of this story. They were actually called LOLs. Back then, little old ladies, which is, when we think about today, and we know the word, the phrase LOL, but these really were women who changed the course of history.
The memory rope for the Apollo missions, the early computers, the guidance systems. So they were the same women who had been working in textile mills. And so I want to find them more than anything. And if I can't find them, I want to find their children.
So they're actually seamstresses who would take a needle and literally weave code into the computers. And if they did it wrong, that's not going up.
Right, or coming down.
Or coming down, right?
Right.
And that's everything.
Right.
What a unique element. And we're talking about mills in Lowell and in Lawrence.
I know that some of the people worked for Raytheon and the Draper Lab and MIT. And yeah. So I don't know exactly where they were located, but they were all around this area. I found their names.
Let me hear them.
Vernell Norman, Caroline Butler, Helen Lennon, Edna Walcott, and Mary Julian. And I've been looking for them because I wanted them to be here at the Kennedy Library so we could celebrate them or their family members. So I'm hoping that maybe some of the viewers might be able to help us find them.
We hope so too. My mom actually worked for the Draper Lab at the same exact time, and she's since passed, but she didn't talk a lot about what had happened. And I just showed you her pass. It just said her name and a red star. So there, I think that it was so top secret that there weren't a lot of people sharing those experiences at the time.
Right, and I would love to hear the stories they passed down to their children or grandchildren, right, about what, you know, how they felt about the being part of this effort. If you're the children or grandchildren of those women, call WCVB.
Yes, please. And people have already started to email, so we're really excited about that. So basically, the memory for that guidance computer was equivalent to 72 kilobytes. It took these women 8 weeks to weave that software into the core rope memory. 8 weeks. So if you recognize any of those names, like Caroline said, call us right here at WCVB.